Hi everyone, welcome to the 16th video on Python learning series for network engineers. In this video we'll see some string formatting examples and we'll see how to add timestamp into the backup configuration file name. The percentage operator is used to format a set of variables or tuples. You can apply the formatting on variables or tuples. Tuples are immutable objects. That means the value which once it is created, we cannot change the value of that. We will see some examples of tuples as well here. So here percentage s means it is going to be a string and percentage I means it is going to be an integer. So we'll see some examples of string formatting. So for that I'll go to my Python interpreter. It is 3.6. So here I'll create a variable. First we'll see a variable formatting. So variable I'll call name equal to, call this as Dev, enter, then print. Here give hello, then one comma, percentage s, because this one is the name is a string, so I'm going to give a string and exclamatory mark, then here percentage name. What it does, it gives the string value of this variable in the complete output. We'll try to execute this script. Yeah, so now it prints the complete text. So the percentage s is replaced with this variable. Now we'll see another example. Here we will use tuples. So name equals, give Hamilton, enter car equal to, I'll give an integer here, then print. I'll give double quotes because I'll be giving apostrophe s inside that. So percentage s, first I'll give the string Hamilton, then Hamilton's car number is, another is going to be a integer, so going to give percentage I, then I'll close this, then percentage, then I'll create a tuple with the values name comma car. We'll try to execute this. Yeah, now you can see the output here, Hamilton's car number is 44. Another example we'll see with multiple tuples. So we'll create two teams. So fer equal to, this is going to be a tuple, so we'll call Ferrari comma the driver name comma the car number. And another so I have two tuples now. So we'll create a print statement here. So output equals, here in double quotes, so percentage string, first we'll give any car, any team name. So driver, then we'll give the driver name, so that is going to be another string. So for example, Ferrari's driver Vettel, car number is, then another is going to be an integer. So here we'll give apostrophe s, so that Vettel's car is, car number is 5 and Hamilton's car number is 44 will come. Enter, then print output. Percentage will give FER first. Yeah, so Ferrari driver Vettel's car number is 5. Now we'll give Mercedes. Yeah, in that way you can print. So it refers to different tuples for printing a string. So if you want to see the type, so we'll give type of, it is a tuple, and even Ferrari also is a tuple. So tuple means immutable object. Once it is created, its value cannot be changed. Now we'll see how to format our time values. I have created some sample script for printing time. We'll come into this later once we see some examples. So I'll go to my Python interpreter. Here we'll do some sample printing of our time. So print. So first we need to import the library called datetime. Then we'll give print datetime.datetime.now. yeah, so it prints with milliseconds, so this we have seen earlier. Now if you want to print the day, what you need to do is now dot day you can give, so it prints the date. Now if we give month, it gives a month, March 22nd. Then if I give year, it will print the year. Then hour, minute, then second, it prints in that way. So one thing what you can do is, so this is going to be static, so what you can do, we'll call this as TNOW equals now print TNOW dot second equal to 17. So in the same way you can do for any value here, minute. Yeah, so using the same logic I have created a command here. So once you print this, it prints the time, date and time in this format. So here you can see there is no space. Another way to print is using the string formatting. So here what this means is dot 2i means it prints two integers. Even if it is one integer, it will print in two integer. We'll see some demo, then you will understand. So you can see everything, for everything a corresponding integer is there. So for day 2i, month 2i, and year we'll be printing the whole year. Then for hour 2i, minute also there is a 2i, and you can see a hyphen here. So what it prints, day hyphen month hyphen year underscore, then hour hyphen minute hyphen seconds. It will be printing in that way. So we'll see that. So here also we'll be calling the variable TNOW, so there should not be an issue. So we'll try to execute this. Yeah, that also prints the same data. You can see in month I have given 2i. We'll try giving 3i and see what happens, because earlier here we had only 0 3. Once I give 3i, it adds two zeros in front of that in similar way. I can add 3i here also. Yeah, I'll revert it back. This is another way. 2i, and this method and previous this method both prints date and time. You can use any of this. In addition to that, another way is go to help, then here just type topics. Here you can see formatting. So give a formatting, it will be using a dictionary. With dictionary you will be getting a syntax. Will look for percentage, yeah. So based on types specific formatting, you can see here. So they have given one sample here. We'll try to execute this. This is one example where what they are saying. So you can give it in this way, percentage y hyphen m hyphen d. So it prints in this way. It'll be one of the easiest method to print date and time. So you don't have to give this lengthy command. So we'll try this command. I'll copy this. We'll paste it into Notepad. We'll call this as T format. Format equal to this. This is called dictionary. We'll see more details about dictionary in upcoming videos. And here they are calling it as D, but here you can see they are calling D equal to datetime.datetime, and they have given a particular date. So here we'll be using our current time, so we need to use TNOW. So format, we need to give TNOW format, then print T format. We'll see how it prints. Yeah, here you can see there is a space. We'll try to edit that as well, and we'll change the order. First we'll give day, and third we'll give a year, then we'll add one underscore here. We'll see what happens. Yeah, now it prints in a proper way without space. Now we can add this into our configuration backup script. So for that, I'll go to the script and I'll create another file here. /12_backup-timestamp.py. Open. I'll paste it here. We already have this TNOW, so what we can do is we'll call this T format here. We have already imported even the date time library in the previous script. Now we need, addition to that, we'll add TNOW here, T format here. Now what it does, it adds in the file name, it adds router underscore router IP plus T format. If you want, you can add a additional underscore here so that we'll be able to differentiate the router IP and the time. We'll save the script, we'll try to execute it. Python 12. We'll go to the folder. It has taken backup of 10. Yeah, it has taken backup of 11 as well. So you can see now backup is having proper timestamp. If you give the list view, you'll be able to read it properly with the exact timestamp, and each file will be unique now. So I hope this video was helpful for you to understand how to take backup of device to an external server with timestamp in the file name. So from next video, we'll start looking into NetMiko. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.